Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be discussing the IC695GCG001 Genius Communications Gateway. We're going to talk a little bit about the device itself, what it does, and some of the other devices that you'll need to use with it, and how to configure it and get yourself going with it. All right. So the first thing I wanted to point out is pretty much the system that I have going on right here in front of you. It's an IC695PSA140 power supply, an IC695CPE330, along with the power pack that goes to the 330, which is an IC695ACC412. Okay? And of course, the device itself, the IC695GCG001. This is all currently in an IC695CHS012 rack. You can also use a 016. And I also have, just for an example, a Genius block and a handheld monitor. I'm using a IC660BBD110 Genius block and an IC660HHM501 handheld monitor. Okay, so this is just an example system. A couple things that I wanted to point out. I have a straight Ethernet cable that's going directly from my PNC001 PROFINET controller to the GCG001. And the point I'm trying to make here is that it's not a crossover cable, it's just a straight Ethernet cable going directly in port 1. And out of serial B, I have a serial cable going to the serial port on my Genius lock. Okay, so a few wires here. And then last but not least, in order to power up this device, since it's not actually connected to the chassis, you will need an external 24 volt power supply, DC, okay? So this wire is going to my 24 volt DC power supply into the bottom of the module where it's connected. And again, I just want to remind you guys, this is not actually connected to the rack, so it's not using one of the slots, which is something that'll become important when we go to configure this. It's actually screwed into the rack at the top and the bottom of the module, and it's covering over my expansion port, okay? So that's what it would look like when it's connected. So a couple quick things about this GCG that might be important to you. What it does is it interfaces Genius IO devices on a Simplex Genius serial bus to a PROFINET IO controller, okay? Now its job is to scan Genius devices that are configured to it, and it'll be retrieving input data and providing output data, okay? So moving on to configuring this, before we start configuring it, I just want to let you guys know I'm looking in the manual that comes with it, which is the GFK2891A, it's GFK-2891A, and a couple things that are mentioned in here that are very important. You must have an Rx3i CPU with a firmware 8.0 or later to use this device, okay? So again, have to have a processor with an 8.0 or later version firmware. You also have to have your programming software, Proficy Machine Edition, version 8.0 or later. Okay, so again, CPU and software 8.0 or later, has to be. Another thing that you're going to need to do, and I'll briefly touch on this later, is that prior to actually establishing this GCG, you need to get what's called a General Station Description Markup Language. This is the communication between the PROFINET and the Genius Communications Gateway, okay? That's called a GSDML file. You can get this GSDML file by going to your GE Intelligent Platforms webpage under support. You go to support home, and under search you just simply type in the letters GSDML, and you need to download the file that goes along with that, the language file that goes along with that. And when you go to establish this GCG within the PNC, as the GCG acts as a daughter to the PNC, you'll need to download that language before you actually download the processor, okay? So again, I'll briefly touch on that in a moment. Another thing is that the module configuration for the PNC001 network speed has to be changed from 1 gigabyte per second to 100 megabytes per second. So it's got to be reduced a little bit. All right, that's another thing to keep in mind. Make sure that you do. All right, now having said that, I'm going to go into Proficy Machine Edition, and I have a new file here that's untouched, but it has the basic physical configuration that I just pointed out. So again, the CHS012 rack, the PSA140 power supply, the CPE330 processor, and the PNC001 PROFINET controller module, okay? So it's otherwise basically a blank file. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on the PNC, and I'm going to go down in this window to Add IO Device. And this is where I find my Genius Gateway communications. Now, what you would do is after you've downloaded the GSDML, you want to click here where you see my arrow and then go through and browse to find that file and download it to this file so that when you actually do the processor download, it will download to the processor and allow this whole system to work. And I'm also going to give you an example of if you've skipped this step accidentally. Okay, now I'm going to expand on where it says Genius Gateway. Okay, and I'm going to click on Genius Communications Gateway, IC695GCG001, and select OK. Now I've got my Genius device, okay? The reason this is important is because, as I mentioned before, the Genius Gateway Genius Communication Gateway isn't actually in a slot. As I mentioned, it's a daughter to the PNC001, the PROFINET controller, okay? So, now that I have this device configured in, I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to drop down, and I'm going to go to Change Module List. As I mentioned before when I was showing you guys, I'm using a BBD110 Genius block just as an example. And here's where the example is important. You can expand on these input and output modules to find the Genius device that you've chosen. I chose a BBD110. So I'm going to expand on my input modules and left click and hold down, drag this over to location number one, let it go. And now if you have any other Genius devices, which I'm assuming you will, you just continue to take, click, and drag them over one at a time in their proper locations. All right, and that's obviously 1 through 31. Now, so that's the only Genius device I'm using for this example, BBD110, it's there. I'm gonna select OK. And we're gonna connect up to the controller. Now pay attention down below. I'm in monitor mode, it's stopped, disabled. That means that the processor is not in run mode and that the inputs and outputs are disabled. Configuration and logic are not equal, okay? Because what's in the processor right now is not what's in front of me. So we're gonna need to do a download. So I'm gonna hit the handprint, puts me in programmer mode. I'm gonna go to my target, online commands. I'm gonna go to clear. Now follow my arrow, the configuration and logic are not equal, I want to do a controller and IO fault table clear. All right, and select OK. Just those bottom two selections, and that'll keep us from getting hung up when we actually do the download. All right, next thing is download and start active target. Okay, it's this download information with run button in one. Now for this example, I'm only going to do hardware configuration and motion and logic just to get it into run mode and show you guys a couple other things. Okay. Now once it's downloaded, it's going to ask us if we want to output enable. Yes, we're going to do that. But the next thing is we need to establish communication, make sure that a communication is established between the PNC and the communications gateway. So I'm going to right click on the PNC, go down to Launch Discovery Tool. Okay, that's Launch Discovery Tool. Click on that. And this PROFINET DCP Direct Connection page will open up. Okay, and so far we don't have anything underneath here. So what we'll do is refresh our device list. and it's going to go through and see if it can find our GCG and PROFINET controller. Alright? Okay, so it's showing us that it has these controllers, and it's showing us the IP addresses that were established to them. Of course, I'm just using the default addresses on these, but it shows you that these two, the status is that they're assigned and then they're communicating with each other. Okay, and that's what you want to see. So, going back to what I mentioned before about downloading that language, the GSDML, if you guys have missed that part, you will not, this, when you hit the refresh device list, it's going to continue to search and it won't find anything, because it's not, you know, talking at the rate that it needs to in order for them to see each other. So please make sure that you don't skip that step. GSDML, it's found in the GFK2891A under configuration section 3. And incidentally, there's one other manual that you can download from your GE Intelligent Platform support, and that is the PacSystem's Rx3i Genius Communications Gateway User Manual. This is the big manual, and it has more information in it. In case you guys get hung up, I recommend this. It's GFK-2892A. All right, so make sure that you guys keep your eye open for that if you need further help. I thank you for watching this, and I hope that it helped you. Thank you.